period of adolescence between the ages of 10 to 19 is a critical developmental stage. But it's more than just the physical changes that we see that's taking place. As mental health counselor with the Ministry of Health, Juliet Simmons, explains, the mind is in transition as well.
We understand that adolescent years is very tough on the adolescent, tough on the parent especially. So we kind of overlook a lot of things and we tend to look at it as a phase. We pray that they grow out of it, things like that people say. We'll get through this. But sometimes it's just that. They're just being an adolescent, and sometimes there is more. How we know the difference now is when it affects your functions. When you cannot function, what we would say, quote unquote, normally, do the things that your daily routine, do the things that you need to do. Then we know it's more than just a phase.
For 17-year-old Angelina Villanueva, the transition from high school to junior college challenged her to cope with a heightened level of anxiety.
In high school, I was a very outgoing student, so I'd be the girl that talked to everyone. I ran for student council president, so I was on the student council for a period of time. So I was a very outgoing student. Well, it was a challenge because it was a new environment, and entering into this environment, you have a goal. And it's very hard for us as teens because you're expected to know what you want to do. So you have to know what you want to do. You want to finish within your time period because everyone is expecting you, especially for me, I set high expectations to myself, and after a while I realized that sometimes you can't always meet it. Alongside with having the stress of school, I was also having other stressful moments in my life, so that itself put a toll on me, and it made me realize, because for me at night it was hard to sleep. For me it was the overthinking, so I just sit in bed at night and think, because you just think about everything in general, as in, you know, wanting to fit in, or what people think of you, what people expect of you. And that's hard for us as teens, because you want to be the person that everyone likes, you want to be the person that excels, and it's hard sometimes to balance both of them.
Eventually, the chronic overthinking and crippling anxiety led Angelina and her family to decide to seek out a counselor.
I didn't want to at first, because for me, I see myself as a strong person. So I was like, you know what, I don't need a counselor, I can do this myself. And sometimes you don't realize that you really do need a person. Not for the just, sometimes you just need a person to talk to. And yes, you have it at home, but sometimes you need someone outside of your family household.
Angelina's bout with anxiety is an all too common occurrence for teens. For high school counselor Tashira Swift, she sees firsthand how teens struggle to cope with everyday issues.
Some of the main issues that I've seen them dealing with are those of suicidal thoughts or ideation, attempting suicide, depression, and anxiety, just to name a few. Yeah. As a society, tend to think that young people don't have anything or any problems that they should be bothered by. But we fail to realize as adults that sometimes some of these problems that we are dealing with as adults that we think that they're not paying attention to, it trickles down. And so you might have mommy at home who's struggling to make ends meet and thinking that her son or daughter is not paying attention to that, but then they're at school unable to concentrate, having suffering from anxiety and depression and worried about mommy, you know, who's trying to handle it all.
According to the WHO, globally, 10 to 20% of children and adolescents experience mental disorders.
And the signs and symptoms are there from the adolescent years, as early as 14. So we need to focus on these, on this age group. Well, right now, to what we're concerned about with our adolescents is the suicide attempts. We have a lot of suicide attempts. And that flags for further or another suicide attempt, which could lead to a complete suicide. So those are our biggest concerns.
This is why the development of the research tool and project MMAP, a tool to measure the mental health of adolescents across Belize, and the Health Adolescent Thrive Project is being welcomed by health professionals and those who work with children.
In Belize, we don't know. We don't know what is the state. That is why we have these two studies that we're trying to carry out right now. We don't know the situation right now.
You know, we go to the doctor if we have a pain in any part of our bodies. And similarly, it should become normalized to the point where if I'm suffering with depression, I feel confident and comfortable going to see a counselor.
As for Angelina, after some talk therapy to cope with her anxiety, her adjustment to the new school environment has gotten easier.
For me, it was easier because I had a mom who was understanding. So for her, she saw it easier that maybe for me, it would work that she found someone that can help me in that situation. It's not as bad as it was before, because before I was contemplating a lot of things. And for me, I don't have that pressure on myself, because like my beginning of sixth form, I had that pressure that I must excel, I need to do this. But for me now, yes, I still have that mentality because we need to pass, I mean. But for like now, I don't have as much pressure on myself. So if I get something below what I would have expected myself to get, it's not that much on me, because I realize, you know what, I've learned my lesson. I know what I can do better, and I know what I can change, and I know that I can't always be perfect.